Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bi madadakum wa nazarakum Sayyidi ya Rasul al-Kareem, ya Habib al-Azim, madad ya Sayyidi ya Sultan al-Awliya man Shaykh Abdul Faiz al-Daghestani, Sultan al-Awliya Shaykh Muhammad Nazim Ahmad al-Hakani, Mawlana Shaykh Hisham Kabani, Shaykh Adnan Kabani, Shaykh Muhammad Adil, Mawlana Abdul Khaliq al-Khuj Dawani, Sahib Zaman Sayyid Muhammad al-Mahdi alayhi salam, Ruhullah Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Sayfullah Sayyidina alayhi salam, Tumma Sayyidina Abu Siddiq, Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Uthman, Imam al-Hassan alayhi salam, Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, Sayyidatina Fatima alayhi salam, wa sa'iru sadatina wa siddiqina al-Fatiha. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. InshaAllah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أتي الله أتي رسول أولي الأمر منكم الحمد لله that Allah عز وجل granted us to arrive to the holy Eid al-Fitr. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, that Allah's Akbar and greatness beyond comprehension, and that His mercy is all-encompassing. And the quickest way to that mercy is good manners. That we've talked many times that an extreme example is the magicians who wished to come against Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. And Pharaoh was very angry with Nabi Musa alayhi salam, called him to his presence and said, okay, this karamat, these miracles that you have, our miracles are going to be stronger. And he wanted to humiliate the Prophet of Allah and cause a difficulty, and just to make the whole version shorter, just to remember that everything is based on manners. That he came to the presence of the magicians of Pharaoh's temple, and they were supposed to duel and compare their magic. And the magicians of Pharaoh, they asked Nabi Musa alayhi salam, should we go or should you go? Should you throw first or we throw first and begin this event? And awliyaullah come from the heart of Prophet and describe that one.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nur John, thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Manner opened a door of immense faith. Because these are hardcore evil magicians. All magic now is a drop of pharaonic magic. So these are the worst of the worst. Then Allah describes in Qur'an a series of events that they threw their magic. Nabi Musa said, you go first. They threw their magic. Then Nabi Musa threw his staff and became a dragon from Divinely Presence. And they knew that wasn't magic, they knew that's a creature from Divinely Presence, and it devoured all their magic. One, the importance of the staff, and that importance of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq is a dragon of Allah. And that Islam has dragons and they use dragons. So if you ever start to see that images of dragons, you know, is very deep in Islamic culture and Islamic reality. And since we've been teaching about the reality of the asa, and that asa when put to the down, it became a dragon of Allah and devoured all the falsehood that Pharaoh was trying to manifest. So that's one reality, is the immensity of what Allah has given to the reality of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and upholding the sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad and the immense reality of Divinely support. And when the Divine supports you, supports with the Yansurukallahu Nasran Aziza, in a mighty, immense support. When Allah said, when we support somebody, it becomes an immense support, and that they have dragons supporting them against every type of evilness of this earth. Whatever we see of horror movies and the evilness, they must exist, because you can't draw something Allah doesn't have. You can only manifest from what Allah's creation already exists, from the data file that's already in existence. You can't make your own data file. So imagine all those horrific creatures that we've been able to see through movies and sci-fi, and many that we have absolutely no understanding to. None of them in the face of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, none of them in the face of the sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, none of them can do anything bi'izzatullah in the presence of Allah's might and majesty. So means that what He gave to the nation of Prophet ﷺ is immense, immense realities. And alhamdulillah that they give us the deep understanding, so that to have a reverence for the holy sunnah of Prophet and the great armour that it will provide, is the great protection that it provides against the dajjalic system that will reveal itself more and more. So Allah didn't leave the nation alone. And it's based on the muhibeen and ashiqeen, that because of their love and nearness to the heart of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, these realities are being sent. Because Allah's promise was what? That my awliya, they will neither fear nor grieve. Well, faced with what's coming, you would think there'd be a lot of fear. But then Allah sends a sakina to the heart, say, no, no, we've got dragons ready for you, fire ready for you, a might and majesty from Divine the Presence, there's nothing to fear. Then when Allah wants to open, Allah will open under His oceans of Akbar. That through the aid when we're reciting, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Because every badness and every bad character is completely destroyed in the presence of Allahu Akbar. That whatever you have of badness, whatever we have of bad desires, bad actions, in the presence of Allah's supremacy is nothing even visible. One of the guys put out a nice video showing how we're just the epsilon. Universe in this vastness, you can't even find the Milky Way in this universe. And in that Milky Way you can't even see our earth. And on that earth there's no way to see me and you. Means the vastness of Allah's creation. And from the vastness of that space Allah's Akbar reaches the servant as soon as they begin to call out. With sincere hearts and ashiqeen and love and proper manners that they learn for the love of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So then tariqah comes to teach that because they had a reverence in their heart and they paid a Prophet of Allah respect, and they asked Sayyidina Musa ﷺ, would you like to throw or we'll throw? That simple act of showing respect open their hearts now for the next phase, because as soon as the magic came and Sayyidina Musa brought divinely proof and the dragon appeared, they went into sujood and immediately accepted the miracle and accepted the divinely presence. So from 100% evil with demonic practices and must have been immensely marked and filled with horrific signs, because of that one action Allah opened the heart to immense stations of certainty in which they immediately saw the miracle. Because now today you see people, even if they openly see a miracle, they will talk bad about it. Even if they've had miracles in their life from you, they'll begin to curse you at a later date. Because the heart is sealed and become like a rock. But when Allah opens for His servant, these magicians, they saw the miracle. And as a result of that, they immediately went into prostration and accepted Allah's authority, and that Sayyidina Musa is the Prophet of Allah. And not only that they accepted their Islam, but Pharaoh said, who gave you permission? Now I'm going to torture you. I'm going to rip you from side to side and torture you because of your belief and that you humiliated me in the presence of Sayyidina Musa. And their answer was, whatever you do to us doesn't matter. What our Lord has in store for us is far more supreme. People don't even say that now, and they live a life seeing miracles with you. What type of certainty Allah opened within the heart of the servant, and for what? They did not do Ramadan, they didn't do Salah, they didn't do zakah. They didn't do anything, and they were 500% evil. And that becomes the immense importance, that if people have a heart to understand, have ears to hear and to really know, this system is based on manners. Not what you know, not what you've memorized. Not all the physical actions and worshipping, and people want to look like they're praying very long time and want to talk like they're religious authorities and all of these different things, but that they're manners. And that if you see them off camera or you see them interacting, the manners in which they have, the manners that they have to other people, the manners that they have to the Divinely Presence, everything comes back to the manners and adab. Adabana Rabbi fa ahsanu fi tahdi. Allah, Prophet describes, sent me to perfect character, not the sharia. Because all you people can argue all day long, your sharia is wrong, our sharia is right. And they can become proud of actions, they can become proud of their giving and their worshipness and their practices. And Prophet reminding us, because Ramadan we've now been dressed like newborn children, and Allah giving us a great reset, that go out now into the world as pure, like newly born children, and build the foundation of your faith based on good manners. And the best of manners to those whom agitate and aggravate you, not only to the good manners to the ones whom praise you, but good manners to those whom oppose you. The way is established based on these good manners. And this manners stored in childhood, in youth. It's very difficult to teach adults manners. Because they're ingrained with behaviors and characteristics like a dog that already been trained. You know how difficult it is to break down the manners of a trained animal and retrain it into something else? And why we give the example of an animal, because our character without manners is just a talking hayawan. We're just talking animals. When we try to reach to angelic realities is completely different. Otherwise we're just a talking baboon with no manners, no good character, but we have a voice box and we can put words together. But what Allah wants for us is train at an early age the way of manners and the way of adab. And the one whom doesn't have manners, then you can look to the family and think why they didn't teach their youth. They let them to be wild and then later when they have difficulties they bring them like wild creatures. The shaykh, now let's see what tariqah can do. What the tariqah is going to do has already been trained. And in most cases if it's untrained, this dunya make these creatures to be very aggressive, very rude, very bad character. So means if the whole key of our life and our success, because as adults this knowledge should be that everything is based on manners. I pray a lot, I do my awrads, I do my, all my meditation and my practices, it's key to opening is the adab. Faced with bad character they remain in good manners. Allah will test you. Some have asked, oh when shaykh, when you're not around everybody is very rude and aggressive with each other. And Mawlana Shaykh described, anywhere we are in life Allah will put us in a bag and we become rocks in a bag. And the best way to polish rocks is shake the bag. So people can't complain, why is like this, why is like that, how are you going to be polished? If things at work don't aggravate you, people around you don't aggravate you and the brotherhood and sisterhood doesn't aggravate you, how will you be polished? But most are concerned about if someone agitate me, I must agitate them back. But then that's not somebody training in good manners. The one whom is training in good manners knows that they are in a bag to be polished. And what they want is to be refined, and all of the garbage of the stone has to be cut until it becomes like a very precious stone where it has been cut, you know, masterfully cut. So now that it has a value for Allah, that this was charcoal, it became semi-precious. Now as a result of the testing in its life, it's become like a cut stone, a precious stone, has value to Allah. And it starts by our youth, teaching them the basic manners in life, that when you see an adult, get up and offer your chair, offer your place. Don't keep the children seated while others are standing. Teach the children to be of service, take this water go serve people, take this go give to the people. When people tell you don't talk, say sorry and keep yourself to be silent. But if you teach the children to be like a wolf, if anyone say anything to you, bite them. Then this is not the tariqah. And that wolf will one day eat you later. And that becomes the difficulty. If their adab is not trained in youth, they're very difficult to reach as adults. That's the tariqah training, all from Prophet ﷺ, that when an adult enters and a child is sitting on a chair at home, get up and offer the chair to your father and to your mother. Don't let them to sit and have bad manners that you go somewhere else and sit. When you're looking at your own child like, get up, I'm gonna hit you in the head. Teach them the good discipline, good character. When you teach them at home, Then when you come out to a community, that's your time to shine, that look, they've been trained. That my kids can look at my eyes and know when they're in trouble. You don't have to train by your hands moving like it's a clown. You should have done that at home. And when you go out in public, they merely look in your eyes and know trouble's coming, or that you're happy and everything's going to be great. So it means we went from the highest point now to the children. And because of Ramadan, the reason is that there's so much time together. Ramadan is a time when 30 days people are coming together a lot, and by mid-Ramadan they're all sending emails complaining. They're tired of this person, tired of that person, tired of this kid, tired of that kid. And because of the closeness and the time being spent with each other, it becomes like extended family time, where others now get to observe the characteristics of the children and other people's children. And that's what's so important, because all of this is a part of our own self-observation. If we observe that the system is wrong, the child is being disciplined wrong, the understanding is being wrong, it's crooked. And if you give it a few more years, that person going to be way off track and become impossible to bring them back into the fold and back to the reality that Prophet wants for them. But if they're disciplined in the way, disciplined in the manners, disciplined in the ways of Prophet, which we call tariqah, but these were the adab and the manners that Prophet was teaching his holy companions, how to eat, how to share a space, how to get up and move for an adult, how to be of service to an adult, go and get them water if they're eating. At the time they would bring the bowl for them to wash their hands after their food. Our life was to train how to be of service, how to be of service. So that when you became older, it was already in your custom, it was in your nature. And then you were 100 times more advanced than other people, because they don't have that in their nature, they didn't understand. And it creates a sense of humility within our being. And later we found in life what that was the key to all of tariqah. It wasn't who memorized the most hadith and who memorized the most Qur'an and who, you know, prayed the longest and had the qirat that was most amazing, but it was the manners. If the servant didn't have the manners that were pleasing to Allah, then they were definitely not pleasing to Prophet ﷺ, and as a result not pleasing to any of the awliyaullah fi samai wa fil ard. A reminder always for myself in this Eid night is that the key to our spiritual success and success in our dunya by Allah's rida and satisfaction. And the satisfaction of Prophet be upon us by good manners for ourselves, our family and our community. Subhana rabbika rabbal izzati amma yasifoon wa salaamun al mursaleen walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Bi hurmati Muhammad al Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al Fatiha.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nur John, thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.